guys, welcome back to my channel. It's finally here. I finally did this darn skincare routine video that you guys have been requesting for a while now. Thank you so much for everybody constantly commenting, DMing me, asking me to do my routine, and I have finally done it. This video is going to be a combo of both my daytime and nighttime routine, but the clips that I'm going to be putting into this video are going to show you the steps that I did for my daytime routine. Then for the nighttime, I'm just going to talk to you about the products because some products I do carry over from day to night, but I'll talk about them. I'll show you all the products, all the little extras that I do every now and then that are not part of my everyday routine, but I still use these products occasionally. I'm gonna make sure I include them too. So let's get right into the video. So it's morning right now, and I have just finished doing my morning routine. So this is what I look like after I have completely finished everything, done all the steps, put all the products on. I will definitely insert some footage of what I look like without any of those products on my face at all. Complete, barefaced, no makeup, no product, nothing, fresh out of bed almost. So you can see what my skin really does look like first thing in the morning after waking up. Because I think sometimes depending on how good your products are, even without makeup, when you put your skincare on, your skin looks a little better, brighter, fresher. I think I look a little fresher now than before I began my routine. But let's get right into my steps and all the products. First things first, cleansing. All the products that I'm going to talk to you guys about are all products that I've been using anywhere from around a month to years. Some of these products I've been using for a very long time. So this is going to be as thorough of a routine as I can give you guys. One is Cetaphil. This is the one that I actually did use in the demo. It's what I'm going through right now. It's really down to the end. And once this is done, I'm going to move on to my Youth to the People. This actually comes with a pump, but it's separated when you purchase it and you put the pump on yourself. So I haven't done that yet, but it does come with a pump, which of course I love pumps. Cetaphil comes with its own pump. And this one is actually a glass bottle as opposed to plastic. So I'm really enjoying not needing to be too careful with this one, but I know this one, definitely I need to be a little bit more careful with, baby it a little bit because it is glass, but it's beautiful. It's beautiful sitting on your bathroom sink. But definitely be careful. Don't put it anywhere up high that it could possibly fall and break. But this is the kale and green tea spinach vitamin superfood face wash. And I've actually got several minis prior to this full size. This is my first full size. And I love this cleanser. Way more expensive than Cetaphil, definitely. You can get this at any drugstore, probably. This I got on Sephora.com. I'll put all links below to all of the products I talk about, don't worry. But I really do love this, and I've been using Cetaphil now for probably the last maybe 2 years on and off. Sometimes I'll try samples, or I'll go back and forth with some other cleansers I have hidden away. But I really do love this, and it's affordable and so easily accessible. I can just go to any drugstore around, grocery store even, Walmart has it too, and just pick this up. So, you know, if I run out of this, I have to, you know, it's a little bit more of a journey for me to go in store to a Sephora to get it, if they even have it in stock, or order it online. But for now, these are my two go-tos. So as soon as I'm done this, I'll move on to this one, but they're both amazing cleansers. Next is toning, and I have two toning options here. I have my Bioderma, and this is my moisturizing toning lotion of choice, my hydrating toner of choice, and I have an acid toner of choice, which is my Ordinary Glycolic Toner. Both of these tone your face, but personally, I prefer to keep the hydration for AM and the exfoliating for PM. So I would only use this in the AM. and I would only use this in the PM. So it depends on how you like to do your toning, but that's what I recommend. Acids, as I've told you guys in my previous videos, if you haven't watched them, go check them out. Acids can make your skin extremely sensitive to the sun. And of course, we're all wearing our SPF, right? So I kind of feel a little better leaving my acids, any acid, for evening time for the most part. I do have an acid type product that I'm gonna talk to you guys about in a second that I use during the day, but it's for good reason. But generally, I prefer this at night and this in the morning. And these are both pretty affordable. This is more than this, but The Ordinary is a very affordable brand, also found at Sephora and on Deciem's website. This I purchased on Amazon, but I know it is also available at Beautylish. The next step in my morning routine is essence. Essences, I haven't been using them for that long, maybe about a couple of years now. I didn't really think it was something that I needed. I heard, you know, a lot of people talk about it, especially in the Asian beauty community. Korean skincare, Japanese skincare, love. They're all about their love of essences. So I finally decided to try one, and I really do feel like it does plump my skin, give me that extra layer of hydration. I really do feel that it makes a difference. And the one I'm using currently is from Fresh. This is their Black Tea Kombucha Facial Treatment Essence. And I really enjoy using this. It absolutely does feel good and make my skin look good, help with makeup application. I feel like AM is the time for you to really feed your skin with as much moisture and hydration as possible, because you wanna look plump and fresh. And also too, if you're a makeup wearer, it really serves you well for giving you a great base for makeup application. Next, I always use a serum in my daytime routine, and I'm gonna show you two that I'm currently using right now. One from The Ordinary that's very affordable, their hyaluronic acid, and one from Tatcha that is not affordable, and it is their Violet C Brightening Serum. Now I use both of these because I'm all about getting in as much moisture as possible during the day, especially if I know I'm gonna go in with makeup. I don't want my makeup catching on any dry, flaky patches. Nothing like that. I don't need that kind of drama in my life. So I go in with Tatcha first because I like to move from thinnest to thickest. That's what we should all be doing with our skincare products. No matter how many you use, always go from thinnest to thickest consistency. So this is definitely thinner than this. So I go in with this. And this is what I was referring to earlier when I said I prefer to leave my acids for the evening. This is the exception, because not only does this product have vitamin C, but it also has 10% AHA as well. So I make that an exception because it's a combined product. And if any of you out there are trying to justify the price, there you go. That's the number one plus that I can think of about this product that can justify the price a little. If you want to eliminate two steps in your routine, your serum and your exfoliation, get something like this because it has both in it. You get your brightening, evening out of your skin tone, antioxidant fill for the day with the vitamin C, plus you get that exfoliation with the AHAs that are in here as well. Then I follow up with my hyaluronic. This really isn't a very necessary step, and sometimes I do skip it. I don't need to use this, but I like to, just again for that extra hydration. I love to get it in wherever I can, and it's affordable, so I enjoy using it when I have it, and especially during either the hotter months or the colder months. Both times of the year I find this very effective, because when you're out in the heat, the heat dries your skin out, and then when it's cold, the cold wind and snow and rain can also do some craziness to your skin as well. So these are both two serums that I've been using for a while now, and I love them both. Next is moisturizer, and I have two options here. I have Believe, this is their True Cream Aqua Balm, and The Ordinary's Natural Moisturizing Factors Plus HA. Currently, I'm using Believe right now. You'll see me apply it in the demo. I am obsessed with this moisturizer. It smells so good, so fresh. It's a gel moisturizer, which is perfect for my combo oily skin. All of you oilies out there, I highly suggest you converting to solely gel moisturizers. Forget anything else, because this is what is gonna give you the moisture without greasiness. That is what gel moisturizers do. They moisturize without leaving you looking like an oil slick, right? So I love this one. This one is not a gel moisturizer, but it's from The Ordinary and it's affordable, so I decided to try it. And I've been using it now on and off for quite some time. Definitely, I do prefer this more in the cooler months because it is a cream. It's, you know, a little thicker, not heavy feeling at all though, but it is a thicker cream, but I do love it. And I think all skin types would benefit from using something like this. So definitely two great ones to check out. And last but not least, my daytime skincare routine would not ever be complete without SPF. And I have two choices for you, Clinique and La Roche-Posay. I use the La Roche-Posay in the demo because currently it is my go-to. I love the fact that it gives off a matte finish. That is the thing that really has continued to draw me in and make me repurchase this thing. I don't know how many times. I can't tell you how many times I've repurchased this. The SPF is high, 60. It's ultra lightweight, no intense sunscreen smell, no white cast. I have it on right now. Beautiful under makeup. It's perfect. Perfect for combo oily skins or anyone that just doesn't like that crazy greasy look. Clinique is also another great one. This is chemical and this is mineral. This is my number one favorite mineral sunscreen right now, but Clinique is still a fantastic SPF. This one is 30, UVA and UVB protection, no crazy sunscreen smell, no white cast. My number one recommended mineral sunscreen for the face, hands down. And this one is probably gonna be my number one chemical for the face, hands down. Both great options, so you can't go wrong with either one. So that's it, guys, for my daytime routine. I definitely believe that daytime routines should be pretty quick. You don't need a whole lot of steps. The traditional go-to steps for any daytime routine, I think, are just cleansing, toning, moisturize, and SPF. That's really all you need to do. You can eliminate any other steps because they're not that necessary. Those four are the four that I think you really need to stick to. So now I'm gonna move into all the little extra things that I do during my nighttime routine.